Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss vector fields. Let's work through this example. The question is to sketch the vector field f of x, y, z equal to j hat. Let's carefully work through it. Solution. Let's write down our function again. We have the function, and it takes a point in space, so x, y, z, and it spits out the vector j hat. The vector j hat is a special vector. Its components are 0, 1, 0. So for any point in space that we plug into this function or this vector field gives us this vector, which is a unit vector in the direction of the y-axis. Let's give a rough sketch of what this looks like. This will be the z-axis. This is going to be our x-axis. And I'm going to draw the y-axis like this, horizontally. And let's draw our vectors in blue. So basically, any point I pick, I can pick any point. Say I pick a point here. I'm going to get a little vector like this. And it's going to be the same vector. It's going to have a length of 1, and it's going to be in the direction of the positive y-axis. So it's going to be going that way. So if I pick one here, I get the same thing. If I pick one here, I get the same thing. What if I pick one down here? I get the same thing. So basically, you have all of these vectors, and they all have length 1, and they're all going in the direction of the y-axis. Really cool, right? The vector field is a function, which in this particular case takes a point in space and spits out a vector. And the vector it spits out is this one here. It's j hat with coordinates 0, 1, 0. Really interesting. Let's look at an example that is a little bit more challenging than this one. Here is our next example, and this one is a little bit more tricky. The question is to sketch the vector field, and we have f of x, y, z, and this time instead of j hat, it's equal to z times j hat. Let's carefully work through this solution. So let's start maybe by drawing a rough picture of the x, y, z plane. So here is the z axis. This will be z, and we're going to put x down here. And let's put y just like we did before, just make it horizontal. So it's just easier to draw the vectors and easier to think about. So here's y. The one thing you can do in this problem that might help you is you can rewrite the vector field like this. X, y, z, f of x, y, z is equal to, so it's z, and then it's times your unit vector, so 0, 1, 0. So this is equal to, well, you can distribute the z, it's a scalar, it's a real number. So you're allowed to multiply real numbers times vectors, it's called scalar multiplication. So you just get z times 0, which is 0, and then here you get z times 1, which is z, and here you get z times 0, which is 0. This is really cool. And so let's think about it. If we're above the positive z-axis, so here's the negative z-axis down here, this yellow dotted line. So if we're up here, we're going to get vectors going to the right. And the closer we are to zero on the z-axis, the smaller the vector, right? Because it's going to have a smaller magnitude. So down here, we have these little vectors going this way. But if you go up here, the vectors get bigger. And if you go up here, they get even bigger because z is bigger. So the magnitude of the vector is bigger, and so it's going to the right more. Same thing over here. Your vector is bigger. Then over here, it's a little bit smaller. And then down here, your vectors are smaller. And then here, they're like medium size. The higher you go up, the bigger your vectors. But at least up here, they're all going to the right. The interesting thing happens is when you go down here to the negative z-axis. Here you have tiny little vectors going the other way, right? Because the z-axis is negative. And then down here, they get larger in magnitude, and then even bigger down here. So really interesting, right? Really interesting. Takes a lot of thought to, you know, come up with this stuff. So yeah, that's an example of another vector field. So hopefully you've learned a little bit about vector fields in this video. They basically take points and they give you vectors. So you plug in a point into this function, which we call a vector field, and it produces a vector as an output. These are used in physics and in other applications. Hopefully you've learned some mathematics in this video. If you have, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.